welcome back to my channel. So I know this video is going up late. It's supposed to upload on Thursday, and I actually filmed a video. I filmed an eye tutorial to do on Thursday, and I wasn't satisfied with the way it came out, so I didn't upload it. After I'd done the eye look, I started playing around and adding some things off camera after I'd already filmed my tutorial, and I ended up with an eye look that I fell in love with. So I decided just trash that video and come back today, film the tutorial on the eye look that I loved, because I think you guys will enjoy it a lot more than the one that I initially had, because this one is like popping. It is the most dramatic eye that I've probably ever done, but it was beautiful. And the star of the show, I'm going to go ahead and tell you, the star of the show is this Stila Magnificent Metals Liquid Eyeshadow in Diamond Dust. Now these are new from Stila's line. I ordered 3 of these, and this is the only one that I've gotten so far. I don't know where the other 2 are. I emailed Ulta last night, and I haven't checked my email to see if they emailed me back, but there's been a lot going on, and it's been a very hectic week. So we'll figure that out later. Anyway, I'm just blabbering. So if you're interested in this video, and what I'm going to do is a super red smoky eye with an intense metallic lid. It is beautiful. I love it. So if you're interested in watching, go get your makeup, go get your tools. I'll be right here waiting on you, and let's play. Let's put makeup on together, girls. In this tutorial, I'm going to be using a palette and a single eyeshadow plus the Stila Magnificent Metals. The palette I'm going to be using is the Milani. This is in 05 Earthy Elements. And the reason I want to use this palette is because for my blending color, my transition shade and my blending color, I need a mid-tone brown, and then I want an orange. So, and both of these are in this palette. And I used this yesterday for the first time, and this is a really good palette. These eyeshadows are very pigmented, and they were extremely easy to blend. And then I'm going to go in the red that I'm going to use is in shade Stay Golden. It's one of the new ColourPop pressed shadows. It is so pretty. And then the Stila Magnificent Metals, like I said. So to start this look, I'm going to use a large fluffy blending brush, and I'm going to go into that mid-tone brown shade, and I'm going to apply this in and right above my crease. This is going to be my transition color. And I've got my mirror set right here by my camera. So I'm going to kind of turn you guys around. That way I can lean in here to my camera and you guys can watch what I'm doing. Yeah, you can see good. Alright, so with that mid-tone brown and the large fluffy brush, we're just going to start applying that in windshield wiper motions back and forth as our transition color. Right above the crease. In the crease and right above it. Don't take it all the way up to your eyebrow, though. But we want this color to take up above the lid and in between the eyebrow. We want this color to take up that whole area. Make sure you take your time and you blend it well. If you don't blend your eyeshadows, you end up with a mess. Same thing on the other eye. Windshield wiper motions back and forth. Might have to do a little circular motions there. These shadows are really, like, I'm surprised. I don't know why. Milani's a really good brand. I haven't tried anything that I don't like from Milani, but I've had this eyeshadow palette for quite some time. Since, like, November, I think, and I never used it. So, when I used it yesterday, I was like, wow, guys. Alright. So, now that I got that shade on there, and I've got it blended, I'm going to go in with the orange shade I was mentioning in the palette with the same brush, the same fluffy large blending brush. I'm going to tap into that, and basically right on top of the shade that I just put on my eye, I'm just going to go over it with the orange, but I'm going to bring this one into my crease like the brown we did, like in the crease and above. This one we're doing definitely in the crease and blending it out above into the brown. So it'll be like a gradient color effect, you know, on my eyes. And this orange, whoo, it packs a punch. It's a warm toned orange. I have some bright oranges and peaches, but for this look, I needed more of a warm toned orange. And this one is perfect. So I'm doing the same thing. I'm just blending back and forth, making sure I got that color nice and blended. for the other eye. No, I did do my face makeup first before I did this eye, but I will give you a tip. If you are messy with your eye makeup, you may want to do your eyes before you do your face makeup, because this look potentially could have a lot of fallout, especially with the metallic eyeshadow from Stila. It does have some fallout. Okay, so there we go. We have those two colors, which is going to be our transitioning colors. We're going to go from dark to lighter, and it's going to fade. So right now, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to highlight my brow. I'm just going to use, in this palette, I'm going to use this right here, this lightest. I think this is actually probably like for a highlighter. It says base, but I'm going to go ahead and use that. And I'm just going to apply that right under my brow, starting right at the arch, bringing it down. And then I'll go over here and swipe what's left on my brush on. I normally don't do a shimmery brow highlight, but this look is going to be extremely shimmery anyway, so it's not gonna hurt. So I'm gonna put this right here on my brow, and it kind of cleans up the edge of that mid-tone brown, the transitioning color, and it'll just, you know, make it fade even more beautifully. I'm so excited to do this eye look for you all, guys. If you recreate this and you do this, let me know, because, oh, it's beautiful. Wait till you see it. You're going to be hunting for some red eyeshadow, and you're going to be on Ulta ordering you some Stila, honey, because I'm telling you, these magnificent metals, oh my God, beautiful. I'm going to use my e.l.f. Makeup Lock and Seal. Now, you can use regular eye drops, MAC Fix Plus, whatever you have, whatever you have that you like to wetten your brush with. I had to go in pretty heavily and put several layers of this on my eye yesterday to build it up to the intensity that I wanted. And so through that process, I found that by wetting my brush with this, it helped the pigmentation a lot. I'm going to use just a smaller blending brush. This is a small tapered blending by Luxie. It's one of my favorite brushes. And I'm going to do that. I'm going to pick this red shade up and apply it to my lid. Good grief, Jennifer. If I could fix my mirror and make it stay. There we go. All right. So now with this shadow, what I'm going to do first is I'm just going to tap it on the outer corner of my eyelid. I want to kind of create the shape of a cat eye. So I'm just going to tap. You can watch how I create the shape, and then I'll swap it over into my crease. So first, I'm just going to start applying right here to my outer corner. And then I'm just going to go up and out just to create that cat eye look. And then I'm going to swipe up into my crease. I'm going to keep doing that. So if you need to watch me do it again. This is such a pretty red, but it is just not. You have to use like so many layers to get it the pigmentation that you want. I'm forever on the hunt of a perfect red eyeshadow, and I for sure thought I had it with this ColourPop one. And I'm not saying nothing, that I like it. I like it a lot. I just wish it packed a little more punch. Does that make sense? It's just not as red as I want it to be. I mean, when I say red, I want it to be like, I don't have anything red. Like red, blood red. But anyway. Alright, so I think I'll try this one more time, and then I'm going to start wetting my brush, I think. Because I don't feel like the pigmentation is really getting any more intense now. This is the third layer. And I am swapping this all the way in to my inner corner. All the way in. Alright, yeah, I'm going to wet my brush now. So I'm just going to place a couple drops of this on the end of my brush here, getting it nice and wet. And then I'm going to go into that eyeshadow one more time, and let's see what this does. Ooh, I'm nervous. Same thing, just kind of going with the cat eye, that outer V. This is definitely not the brush you need to be blending with, but right now I'm just trying to pack on some color. I still don't feel like it's intense enough. One more time, girlfriends. One more time. If anybody has any suggestions on a super bright, very pigmented eyeshadow, please let me know, because I want one so bad. I just think a red smoky eye is gorgeous. It is so pretty. Now I'm going to go back in with that smaller blending brush in that same shadow, and I'm going to darken my crease. Now I want my crease to be pretty, pretty dark. We may have to come back in after we do the metallic eyeshadow. We may come back in again and darken this up even further. But I want this to be extremely red. That's what made the whole eye look yesterday was, oh, it was so red. And although red, you know, this is a very bold color. It is so pretty. It doesn't look like, you know, like a clown. And some people may be afraid. Now, I'm going to take my large blending brush. I'm just going to dab a little bit of that orange shadow and blend the edges of this out. But a lot of people may feel, what's the word I'm looking for here? They may be scared. That ain't what I'm trying to say. But intimidated. Maybe intimidated by a bright red smoky eye. But just try it. It is so pretty. It's so pretty on everyone. I love it. All right. So for now, I'm done with that eye. I'm going to go to the other eye, and I'm just going to do the exact same thing I did on that eye. All right. I'm done with my uppers. Except for the middle. All right. So, I think I'm going to go ahead and do my lower lash line before I apply that Stila metallic eyeshadow. Because once I do that, it takes a minute. You got to sit still and let that stuff dry, or you're going to have it all over you. So, to do my lower lash line, I'm going to go in with a pencil brush. And I'm going to pick up, first of all, I'm going to pick up that orange shade. Like, very, a lot pigmented. And I'm going to apply this on my lower lash line. This is beautiful. a lower lash line. Look how pretty that is. It almost makes me not even want to put the red down here too. I'm going to, but I just think the orange by itself is stunning. I want to say something while I'm sitting here putting my makeup on to you guys. Some people have said that YouTube has changed me. And I just want to address that, because YouTube has not changed me. Oh, it's not changed me. It has helped me. The person you're seeing on camera right now, this chatty, makeup-obsessed, girly, you know, girl that you see on Snapchat and stuff, that's me. That's always been me. But I've always felt like I couldn't be me because people criticize me. And YouTube has gave me so much confidence back that I'm like, I don't care. You can like me or hate me. This is my life. I'm 34. I've wasted 34 years worrying about what everybody else thinks. And I'm no longer going to do that. I'm going to be myself. And I'm going to take care of my kids and make sure they're happy. And that's all that matters in this world. Now I'm going to take a flat definer brush. Looks like this. I dabbed it in that red. And I'm going to apply this closer to the waterline than the orange color. But anyway, yeah, YouTube has not changed me. YouTube has helped me. It's all it's done. I'm forever grateful to YouTube. And there's a few certain YouTubers who have inspired me. Like, I can't even describe it. I cannot describe what a blessing. Especially one. And you know who you are. You know. I've already told you. I've been watching her videos forever, and I don't know, it just lit a fire inside of me, like, you know, you can be that, you can be yourself, you can do that, don't be afraid anymore, free yourself to be yourself, right? But anyway. Alright, that's good as it's gonna get. See, even on the lower lash line, while I'm trying to apply that red color down there, it just doesn't want to. I mean, it shows up. You can see it. It just doesn't. I don't know. I'm used to more pigmented shadows, I guess. I don't know. Alright, now, I can't even get none on this darn pencil brush, it looks like. I'm just gonna go back in with that pencil brush and blend the red out into the orange. Gosh, this eye is so pretty. It looks like a sunset or something. Well, I'm getting ready to give you some stars. So, if we want to consider this the sunset. Okay, that looks a little harsh over there on that side. What did I do? Maybe if I can blend the edge of it. Okay, better. Alright. So, are y'all ready? Y'all ready to put the bling bling on our eyes? Now, this stuff is really messy, and it can be hard to work with. I've only used it once, and I made a god-awful mess. So, I'm praying that today I do better. So, if you guys have any of these, or if you order those, beware. They're beautiful, but don't go in all ham, because you're going to have a mess, like I did. I was like, oh, Jesus, Lord. Okay, so, and what I'm going to do with this, I'm going to apply it right here in the inner corner. You can look on my lid and see where there's really no eyeshadow. You know, I left it blank. I'm going to cover my lid with this shadow, taking it up to my crease, and don't go any further than your crease. That's what I did yesterday. I accidentally went above my crease, and it was a mess. So, I'm going to pull my eye out like I always do, and you should not do this, but I do it anyway. And then very slowly, because you can make a mess quickly with this, I'm just going to start applying this. Oh my God, this is so pretty. To my lid. I'm also going to use this for my inner corner highlight. Just dab it on till you get it to the intensity that you want. Alright, so now I'm going to kind of take it right on the lower lash line right here on the inner part. Just for my inner corner highlight. Look at that. So pretty. Oh, you got to be careful. You'll get it all over the place. Alright. So now I'm going to take my small blending brush that I used to apply that red shade. And right on the edge, right where the glitter meets the red, I'm just going to take it and kind of dab it and swirl it. Just to kind of blend it together. The way it's not so harsh looking right there. And then I'm going to take my blending brush and I'm just going to blend into the crease. Kind of cleaning the top of that up. You see what it's doing? Cleans it up. Alright. Then I'm going to take my Smashbox primer water. And I'm going to close my eye. And I'm going to spray it right on my eye. Whoop. There we go. And then. Oh no. I'm going to use my fan. And I'm going to fan it dry. Let that dry. Because this will give you an ungodly amount of fallout if you don't get it on there and get it stuck somehow. So, best thing I can do is just to apply some setting spray and dry it. I also ordered the NYX. Is it NYX? Glitter glue? I don't sound right for some reason. The NYX glitter glue. And that didn't come in my order either. I don't know what happened. When I, like, you know, checked the status of my order, it says that all that was delivered. But I'm missing two of these eyeshadows and my glitter glue and my samples. I didn't get my samples either. Only thing I got in my package was this Oh, and I got these little NYX glitter, face glitter things that I'm gonna play with. This red one I'm excited for. Anyway, that's not the point of this video, but I'm just saying half my order didn't come and it says it's delivered, so I don't know what happened. Maybe the mailman wanted to try some Stila. Alright, so same thing on the other eye. God, I swear, this is just so pretty, you guys. I don't know if it's translating on camera as pretty as it is in life, but this is the most beautiful glitter eyeshadow that I have ever in my life seen. It is absolutely stunning. Stila knocked it out of the park. And this is in shade Diamond Dust. I think I already said that, but I'm going to tell you again, just in case. Just in case you're interested and like ready to buy it right now that you've seen it. It is so pretty. Okay, now same thing with the brushes. Take my smaller blending brush right here at the edge and kind of blend the edges together so it doesn't look so harsh. And then with my large blending brush, I'm just going to sweep it back and forth. Oh God, see, I just got glitter everywhere. And I don't even care. I don't even care if there's some specks up above my, I need some over here now though, on my eyelid. Because this is just beautiful. Alright. Same thing. Closing my eye. Spraying. And I'm going to fan. Where's the lid to my primer water? My cousin came over a couple weekends ago and I was doing her makeup and I was fanning her face like this, you know, like I slapped her right in the face with it. I was like, whoopsh. I didn't mean to. She was like, oh my God. I was like, I'm so sorry. I hit her hard too. It wasn't no easy thump. I mean, it was like a whoopsh. Anywho, okay. So now, okay, I think I'm done with that. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to line my waterline with, this is the Jordana Best Liner for Brow and Eye. It is in number 42, Blackest Black. I'm going to take this and I'm going to apply it to my waterline from the outer all the way to the inner corner. Then I'm going to tight line with it. So, get your eyeliners, girls. Here we go. I'm gonna be wearing this daily. You gonna be sick of glitter. Y'all need to follow me on Snapchat. I know most, a lot of you do, but some of you don't. I love Snapchat. I play on Snapchat all day long. If I fart, I put it on Snapchat. Not really. Alright, so now it's time for mascara. And I'm going to use my Benefit Roller Lash. This is my holy grail stuff. I'm going to start on my lower lashes. Alright, so now this can either be your finished look or you can apply lashes. I am going to apply lashes. I'm going to apply the Morphe lashes. They're a little bit dramatic, and that's what I want for this eye, because this is a dramatic eye. And when I put these lashes on yesterday with this eye, I was like, whoop, yep, that did it. It changes the look. It doesn't really change it, but it helps the look dramatically. I will show you. Let me put my lash on. You know I love it when you put your lash on. Alright guys, I hung up with my daddy. My cousin was in a really bad car accident last night and he was calling. We was talking about it. But so if you don't mind, please keep my cousin in your prayers. He's alive. He's going to make it. He's now stable. He was in critical. Then he was serious. He broke every bone in his face and he's going to brain bleed and knocked all his teeth out. Steering wheel messed him up. But anyway, this is the final look. I put the other lash on while I was talking to my daddy. And for my lips, I just have on the ColourPop Ultra Glossy Lip in Aquarius. It's one of the Kathleen Lights collaborations. It's just a really pretty nude lip gloss. I don't want anything bold. I don't want to draw attention to my lips. I want my eyes to be the focal point, you know, first thing people see. So anyway, I absolutely love, love, love this red, sparkly, smoky eye look. I hope you guys do too, and I hope you enjoyed this video. So anyway, I'm going to try to get this edited tonight and hopefully have it up by tomorrow. Today's Thursday, so hopefully tomorrow, Friday, I'll have this up. If not, I'll get it done Saturday, you know. I got some stuff going on at the house. I'm not just like, I can't just sit and edit today. I've got something that's going to take up the rest of my day that I have to do. But I love you guys, and thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing to my channel and supporting me. Tell your friends to come watch. You know, I want my channel to grow so bad. And I know that if it's meant to be, that it'll be. God will make it happen. But just thinking ahead to the future, I need my channel to grow. Me and my children need it to grow. But anyway, I'll just keep praying for, you know, whatever God's will is, it'll happen. And keep my cousin in your prayers. He still needs some prayers. He has a long road of surgeries and recovery ahead. But, today's Thursday, and we got some very sparkly red eyes, and I love it very much. So, I will see you guys on the next one. I love you. Have a great weekend.